Good morning, dear students. Hope all of you are fine. I am also fine. So, in our previous class, we were discussing about the solutions, the second topic of physical chemistry. So, in last class, we mainly covered what is a solution. So, what types of solutions are there? What are the components present in the solution? These are the things we had discussed in our previous class, right? So, in today's class, let's discuss the concentration of solution. We had discussed about solute, solvent, everything in our previous class. Binary solution, all these things in our previous class. Let's revise types of solution. We had discussed various types of solutions such as solid solutions, liquid solutions, gaseous solutions. We have discussed various types of solutions, right? So, now let's discuss concentration of solution. So, what is concentration of solution? What do you mean by the concentration of solution? Yes? So, the composition of solution. The composition of solution. That means the solution composition can be expressed in terms of concentration. I'll give you an example here. You can see so here I took two glasses of water, A and B. Both contain same volume, 250 ml and 250 ml. Okay, here, so this is said to be solvent, right? I took only water of same volume, that is solvent, right? I took the solvent of same quantity, In A, I added 1 spoonful of sugar. I added 1 spoonful of sugar. In B, I added 5 spoonful of sugar. Then, this is also said to be sugar solution and this is also said to be sugar solution. Is it correct or not? Yes. In both the cases, A is also a solution and B is also a solution, then what is difference? What is the difference between A and B? Composition. So that means here the composition is, so in 250 ml of water, only 1 spoon of sugar is present. But what about the composition here? In 250 ml of water, 5 spoons of sugar are present. Both are sugar solutions only. Then what is difference? Then the difference is in concentration. B is having more concentration than A. Then how can you say, sir, how you are saying B has more concentration? Because, first of all, let me define what is concentration. Concentration is defined as amount of solute present in given amount of solution, right? Here, in the given amount of solution, the amount of solute is less, therefore it is less concentrated. Are you following? Here, in the given amount of solution, the amount of solute is high, therefore the concentration of B is more. Once again, let me tell you, right? So, we can determine the composition of solution based on the concentration. What is concentration? Concentration is nothing but the amount of solute present in given amount of solution, given amount of solution or solvent. Understood, right? Now, there are various units to measure concentration. There are various units to measure concentration. So in what terms, in which units we measure concentrations? Now we are going to discuss various units so we used to measure concentration. For example, if anybody asks you what is your height, you may express your height in centimeters, you may express your height in meters, you may express your weight in foot, right? So like this, you can measure your height in various units. Is it correct or not? Yes. In the same way, concentration is also measured in various units. Let's discuss the various units used to measure concentration. Okay, let's discuss one by one in detail. So hope you understand, right? In today's class, so we are going to measure the units of concentration. What is concentration? Concentration is nothing but the amount of solute present in given amount of solution. The amount of solute present in given amount of solution or solvent is called as its concentration. Example, I have given one general example. So if both the glasses contains 250 ml of water, glass A contains only 1 spoon of sugar, glass B contains 5 spoons of sugar, both are said to be sugar solutions, but B is more concentrated, but B is said to be more concentrated solution. Why? Because it contains more composition. It contains more composition than the A. Is it correct? Understood? Yes. Now let's discuss the units of concentration one by one in detail. There are various units. Let's discuss one by one in detail. So definitely in this part, there is a chance to come one more question from this part. That means the units of concentration, out of these units of concentration, there is a chance to come one more question in your public examination, right? Listen carefully. Listen carefully. Yes, first one. Mass percentage. So, what is mass percentage? So, here the solute is also taken in mass. Here, so the mass percentage is said to be the amount of solute in mass dissolved in the given amount of solution in mass. That means here solution is also taken in mass only and solute is also taken in mass only. That is mass by mass percent. That is, we can also call it as mass by mass percent. Okay. So here we can write. Mass percent is equals to, here we can write mass percent is equals to amount of solute in grams, amount of solute in grams, or you can say mass of solute. That means we have taken mass of solute in solution, mass of solute in solution by total mass of solution into 100. So hope you understand. So it is defined as the mass of solute. So the mass of solution is defined as, mass percentage is defined as mass of solute in solution divided by total mass of solution into 100. Or we can say the mass of solute present in 100 grams of solution. So clearly I will tell you what is mass percentage. It is defined as, so the mass of solute, how much mass of solute is present in 100 grams of solution. Okay, that means here the solution is also taken in mass and solute is also considered in mass. Okay, for example, I'll tell you example by that you will clearly understand. So here 5 grams of you can say 5% mass by mass, 5% mass by mass, 5% mass by mass of glucose solution means 5 grams of glucose present in 100 grams of glucose solution. So here one thing, here the solute is also taken in mass and solute is also taken in mass and solution is also taken in mass. So what is mass percentage? It is the mass of the component present in 100 grams of solution. It is the mass of component present in 100 grams of solution. That's why mass percentage is given as mass of solute in solution divided by total mass of solution for how many grams? 100 grams. That's why into 100. Hope you understand, right? So example, 5% mass by mass of glucose solution means, that means 5% of glucose solution contains what? 5 grams of glucose as solute in 100 grams of solution. Understood? 5 grams of glucose in 100 grams of solution. Understood? Right. This is about mass percentage, which is denoted by m by m. Mass by mass. That means solute is also taken in mass and solution is also taken in mass. Hope you understand, right? So note it. So mass percentage is equal to mass of solute in solution divided by total mass of solution into 100. So example, 5% of mass by mass means glucose solution. So that is 5 grams of glucose present in 100 grams of glucose solution. Note it down. Next is volume percentage. Next is what? Volume percentage. Second one, volume percentage. This is same as mass percentage only. In mass percentage, the solute and solution both are taken in mass. But here, the solute and solution both are taken in volume. That's it. So, therefore, volume percentage is defined as, so the volume of solute present in total 100 ml of, right, 100 ml of solution. So it is defined as, that is volume percentage, once again I will repeat, volume percentage is defined as, so the amount of solute in ml, that is volume, present in 100 ml of solution, that's it. So that is, here it can be written as, we can denote it as V by V. So volume percent is equals to mass of solute in solute, sorry. Volume of solute in solution by total volume total volume of solution into 100. Hope you understand what is volume percentage. It is the amount of solute in volume present in 100 ml of solution. 100 if it is mass percentage, you have to take in grams. If it is volume percentage, you have to take it in ml or cm cube. Okay, it is the amount of solute in volume present in 100 ml of solution. Present in 100 ml of solution, that is volume percentage is equals to volume of solute in solution, volume of solute in solution divided by total volume of solution into, for how many ml I told, 100 ml of solution, that's why into 100. So I'll give you example 20% volume by volume, that means 20% volume percent of ethanol solution means what? So here 20 ml of ethanol, 20 ml of ethanol is present in 100 ml of ethanol solution. Hope you understand. So 20% volume, 20% V by V concentration of ethanol means what? 20 ml of ethanol is present in 100 ml of ethanol solution. Got it? Hope you understand. That means we have to take 80 ml water and 20 ml ethanol. If you mix it, what happens? We get 100 ml solution. In that 100 ml solution, how much ethanol is present? Here ethanol is solute. You all know that the one which is present in lesser quantity is solute. Here 20 ml is ethanol, which is in lesser quantity. So, and 80 ml is water, which is solvent. So we get a solution of ethanol. How much ml it is? 100 ml. So how much ethanol is present in it? 20 ml. Therefore it is said to be 20% volume by volume ethanol solution. Understood? Any doubt here? No, right? Sure? Yes. Now let's see mass by volume percentage. Now let's see what the next term, that is mass by volume percentage. So you have written, right? Percentage. You can easily define. I define two things, right? Mass percentage and volume percentage. Similarly, mass percentage. Here, the solute is taken in mass. So we have to take the mass of the solute. But the solution is expressed in volume. So therefore, we can define mass by volume percentage. We can define mass by volume percentage as the amount of solute in mass, the amount of solute in mass dissolved in 100 ml of solution. So ml means that is nothing but volume, that is nothing but what? So volume. Is it correct or not? Hope you understand what is mass by volume percentage. Here the solute is taken in mass and solute is solvent and solution is taken in volume. Let's see what is mass by volume percentage. Mass by volume percentage is equals to mass by volume percentage is equals to mass of solute. Mass of solute dissolved in total volume of solution. Total volume of solution into 100. This implies 10% mass by volume. 10% mass by volume. Sugar solution. Example. See, 10% mass by volume. Sugar solution. Mean what? So, 10 grams of sugar is dissolved in 100 grams of solution. 10 grams of sugar is dissolved in 100 grams of solution. Hope you understand, right? So, that means take 90 ml of water and so dissolve. So 10 grams of sugar in it. So take 100 ml of water and dissolve 10 grams of sugar in it. What happens? We will get 10% of mass by volume sugar solution. That means, so 10 grams of sugar dissolved in 100 ml of solution, which is said to be 10% mass by volume sugar solution, right? So by this we completed 3 units. And the next unit, parts per million, PPM. Have you heard about it? Hope you had studied in class 11. So in first PUC you have studied some of these concepts in the chapter called some basics of chemistry. You read all these concentration terms. If after finishing this class you just revise once the first PUC notes. So that is some basic concepts of chemistry. So there we had discussed various concentration terms. So let's see what is PPM. Note it. PPM, that is called as parts per million. If the concentration or if the amount of solute is very 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 less, then we use the unit called PPM, parts per million. For example, if I want to measure the quantity of sulfur dioxide present in atmosphere, how much percentage of atmosphere contains nitrogen? 78%. How much percentage of atmosphere contains oxygen? 21%. So remaining all gases are very 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 minute. Is it correct or not? So that is why if I want to measure how much sulfur dioxide is present in the atmosphere, then I have to use the unit called PPM. It is nothing but parts per million. For example, I want to measure the certain amount of salt in seawater. For example, I want to measure a phosphate salt in seawater. Seawater is huge. It's like million. Is it correct or not? It's like huge. In that huge water, phosphate salt is very very less in amount. Is it correct or not? So that means the solvent is very more, like million, and the solute is very less. In such situations we use the unit called parts per million. When we will use the unit parts per million? Yes, when the amount of solute is very very less as compared to solvent, then we use the unit called parts per million. What is the part, what is parts per million? How we can define parts per million? It is nothing but mass of solute. It is a part of mass of solute present in million parts of, present in mass of million parts of solution, present in million parts of solution. Therefore ppm, parts per million, is equals to mass of solute, mass of solute divided by mass of solution into, see here, whenever mass percentage we did into 100, why? It is nothing but amount of solute in mass present in 100 grams of solution, that is mass percent. That's it. 100 grams means what we did into 100 we did. Here I am saying million. We are measuring for million of solution. Is it correct or not? So it is the amount of parts of solute present in amount of million parts of solution. Then it should be, that is parts per million is equals to mass of solute by mass of solution, mass of solute by mass of solution into 10 to the power of 6, into 10 to the power of 6. That is nothing but million. Is it correct or not? 1 million is equals to 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs has how many zeros? 6 zeros. That is why it can be written as 10 to the power of 6. Hope you understand. So what is parts per million? Parts per million is a unit used to measure the concentration of solution where the amount of solute is very 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 less as compared to the amount of solvent. Okay, therefore parts per million is defined as the mass of solute in parts to the mass of solution, mass of solution in million parts, in million parts. Understood? Yes. Example, for example, so a sample containing 5 grams of solute, a sample containing 5 grams of solute in 10 to the power of 6 grams of solution. So that means, let's see, here I took 5 grams, a sample containing, a sample containing 5 grams of solute in 10 to the power of 6 grams of solution. What does it mean? For example, I took 10 to the power of 6, that means 1 million grams of seawater. That is the sample I took. Hope you are following, right? So I took 10 to the power of 6 grams of seawater. In it, if 5 grams of phosphate salt is present, if 5 grams of phosphate salt is present in 10 to the power of 6 grams of seawater, then we can say the concentration of phosphate is 5 ppm. 5 parts per million. 5 parts per million. Understood, right? For example, I took 10 to the power of 6 grams of seawater. So that is my sample. In that seawater, it is already a solution. Seawater is already a solution. I want to take phosphate salt. If it contains 5 grams of phosphate salt, then I can say its the concentration of phosphate in that sample is 5 ppm. 5 ppm, that is 5 parts per million. 5 parts per million. So how many units we covered? How many units of concentration we covered? So we covered mass by mass percentage, that is mass percentage, volume percentage, mass by volume percentage, and then what we covered? Yes, parts per million. Now let's go to the very important unit, that is molarity. Yes, you have studied in first PUC molarity, which is denoted by capital M. Hope you had noted this thing, right? So note it. Fifth one, molarity, capital M. Molarity is denoted by capital M. What is molarity? It is nothing but number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. 1 liter of solution, it is the number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. That is molarity is equals to number of moles of solute. You know what is a mole, right? Mole is nothing but, if you consider an element, its atomic mass is nothing but, its atomic mass is nothing but, so it's 1 mole. How much its atomic mass is there? That many grams is nothing but 1 mole. I hope you have studied in first PUC, revise that thing. So it is the number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 liter volume. 1 liter volume of solution. 1 liter volume of solution. Is it correct or not? Yes. 1 liter volume of solution. Number of moles. Number of moles is equals to mass by solute. Number of moles of solute. Let it be NB. Number of moles of solute. NB is equals to mass of solute by molar mass. Is it correct or not? Yes. Volume of solution is nothing but what? Volume per 1000 ml, right? So that is equal to, we can write it as WB by MB divided by V by 1000. Why I put V by 1000? Volume of solution in 1 liter. 1 liter means how many ml? 100 ml. Is it correct or not? So that is equals to, molarity can be written as WB by MB into 1000 by V. Where WB is mass of solute, MB is molar mass of solute, 1000 by V. Understood? All of you understood, I think. Right? So this is about molarity. Molarity. So make a note of it. Okay, I'll tell you an example for this. Finish it, right? Zero point 25 molar NaOH. If anybody asks you to prepare 0.25 molar NaOH, how can you prepare? How can you prepare? See, first of all, you have to find out 1 mole NaOH. What is the 1 mole NaOH? Sodium, we know, at molecular mass. First, you have to find molecular mass of NaOH. Sodium 1 into, what is its atomic mass? 23. Plus oxygen 1 into, what is its atomic mass? 16. Plus 1 into 1, correct? 23 plus 16, 29, 39, 40. 1 mole of NaOH is nothing but 40 grams. 1 mole of NaOH is nothing but 40 grams. That implies 0.25 moles NaOH means how many grams? 10 grams. Are you following what I am saying here? Sure, right? Are you following what is mole? Did you understand what is mole concept here? Yes, here 0.25 mole of NaOH means 10 grams. Why? Because molecular mass is nothing but 1 mole. So that means 0.25 means 1 by 4th of 40 grams. 1 by 4th of 40 grams is nothing but 10 grams. So therefore, 0.25 molar NaOH means 10 gram of NaOH in 1 liter solution. In 1 liter solution. Which solution? NaOH solution. In 1 liter NaOH solution. Did you understand molarity clearly? Very important. So many times they asked questions on molarity, molality and mole fraction. Molarity. Okay? Yes. So once again I'll repeat. What is molarity? Molarity is defined as the amount of solute in moles. The amount of solute in moles present in 1 liter solution. Present in 1 liter solution. The amount of solute in moles present in 1 liter solution. Understood? Yes. Hope you understood. You understood this example also, I think. Now, I'll move on to next concentration term, that is molality. Molality and molarity. It is somewhat sounds same. So many students will confuse. Molality. Don't forget this difference. Molarity and molality. Molality is denoted by small letter M. Molality is denoted by small letter M. What is molality? So, molality is nothing but it is also amount of solute in moles. It is also amount of solute in moles. But present in 1 kg of solvent, not solution, 1 kg, not 1 liter, 1 kg of solvent. Understood? So, molality is equals to number of moles of solute. Number of moles of solute in 1 kg of solvent. 1 kg of solvent. Understood, right? 1 kg of solvent. So that is equals to number of moles of solute. I already told you that mass by mass of solute be WV by molar mass, let it be MV, divided by 1 kg of solvent. 1 kg of solvent means it is nothing but mass of solvent, that is WA. In 1 kg is equal to how many grams? 1000 grams. 1000 grams. That is equal to, what is the formula for molality? WB into 1000 grams divided by MB into WA. This is the formula for molality. Okay. So once again, I'll repeat. What is molality? It is the amount of solute in moles present in 1 kg of solvent. Yes, this is the formula. Example, 1 mole of NaOH, 1 molar NaOH means 40 grams of NaOH dissolved in 1 kg of water. 1 kg of water. Hope you understand, right? Yes. Next, very important point here, molarity is temperature dependent. Molarity is temperature dependent. I'll write here. So first write on this. I'll compare molarity and molality. Let me finish this. I would like to compare molarity and molality. Finished? See, molarity is equals to number of moles of solute, number of moles of solute divided by, so that means number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of solution. 1 liter of solution. Clearly, by seeing molarity and molality, you came to know that molarity depends on volume, whereas molality does not depend on volume. As the temperature increases, volume increases, but mass remains same. Therefore, there is no effect of molarity with respect to temperature. This is very, very important point. So many times these points are asked in public examination. So among molarity and molality, which one is temperature dependent and why? This question is asked in your public examination. Refer your previous papers. Right? One more question they ask. How molarity depends on temperature? Molarity is inversely proportional to temperature. Why? You can see here. Molarity is equal to number of moles of solute by volume of solution. That means molarity depends on volume. As the temperature increases, volume, what happens? It also increases. As volume increases, so what happens to this value? The value decreases. That means as the temperature increases, molarity decreases. As the temperature decreases, molarity increases. Therefore, remember one point. Molarity is inversely proportional to temperature. Molarity is inversely proportional to temperature. Whereas, molarity is independent of temperature, because mass does not change with temperature. Because mass does not change with temperature. Therefore, mass remains constant. Therefore, molarity also remains constant whenever the temperature increases. Therefore, molarity does not depend on temperature. Molarity depends on temperature. How molarity depends on temperature? Molarity is inversely proportional to temperature. Why? Because molarity depends on volume, inversely depends on volume. As the volume increases, molarity decreases. Molarity increases, volume decreases. Hope you understand, right? Yes. Last concentration term, last concentration unit is mole fraction. Last unit is mole fraction. Mole fraction, which is denoted by X. Which is denoted by X. What is mole fraction? It is nothing but the ratio of a particular component in solution to the whole components of the solution. Mole fraction is defined as the ratio of a particular component in a solution to the total number of components in the solution. That is, for example, a solution is made of A, B and C, or AB. A is solute, B is solvent. I want to find out mole fraction of B. Then what is mole fraction formula? It is number of moles of B, that is NB, by total number of moles of all the components, that is NA plus NB. NA plus NB, number of moles of A plus number of moles of B. This is how we can find out the mole fraction. Therefore, in today's class we had discussed various units such as mass percentage, volume percentage, mass by volume percentage, and then parts per million, molarity and mole fraction. Please do revise all these concepts from your first PUC textbook as well as your second PUC textbook. So I'll provide notes. Okay, thank you. See you next class.